Are you saying we should hijack this road?
I think
that science is on all the computer. The sign on the door, it's like reserved for this
student club, that's us, right?
ProgSoc AGM.
Yep.
Performance. Yep. 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 Y
places in the world.
Keep going, please.
Yep.
Lewis, Jacob, Benton. Okay, who was the secretary?
Secretary Nick.
Yeah. Why is he not on the
list? There's an updated one.
Those aren't the official minutes.
So,
I would like to say Nick was secretary for last
year. I say.
Yeah, that's correct.
Alright.
The minutes are missing.
Congratulations, Nick.
Do we accept the minutes otherwise?
Yeah, let's accept.
Alright, we accept them otherwise. I suppose there's no reason to close it out. So we can start with apologies, which is just Tom Donato and who's the one?
And Robin.
Which is Robin. And Robin Bullis.
And Lee Peaks.
Lee? Okay, yep. I don't know who Peaks.
Yeah.
11 minutes. Executive reports.
Okay, Jacob.
So, as president, we had a few events this year. One of them was the STEM Cruise, one of them was the
STEMtacular,
one of them was the one where we're building robots.
STEM
robots? I don't remember. It wasn't STEM
robots. STEM.
What's the difference between STEM Cruise and STEMtacular?
One of them was a bar event, the other one was on a cruise.
Right, but
what's
they're both
three
the bar
events.
Sorry?
Which bar, like Loft or something, for the first one?
It was basically within the first week of uni, just to get all of the new students to see all the STEM stuff.
And this was done in collaboration with the other STEM societies, which are, by the way?
RoboSoft, SciBeSci,
Space.
It was the ship being used to run, but they got rid of all this.
Yeah, that one. We had our VR night with
Dev Diamond.
Dev Diamond, thank you.
I didn't say
it.
Oh, it's an after hour.
Yeah, after Dev Diamond. It's a lot of fun.
Fuck it, that's
fine. Yeah,
Diamond was on
there. Yep.
And, I think that's it.
Didn't you do some seminar as well? You, Robin, and
Selena?
We did a bunch of
Yes, that's right. We did some programming tutorials, just a lot of events.
And that was all in the first semester, yes?
That was all in the first semester. The second semester.
What did we do this semester?
Our focus has been on a room, and unfortunately, it hasn't
worked
very well.
Okay.
Yeah, it's very difficult to get the uni to care about the societies. And so we've had some promise with the new. Student society president pushing for a roof for us, but there was no yield to be had. It's at the end of the day, it comes down to what the uni wants, and the uni doesn't want to give us a room.
So,
what about the dean?
Trying to get one.
I haven't spoken directly to him.
Who is the dean?
I could die.
So, find out who the dean is.
And speak to the dean.
Speak to the dean.
That would be the first agenda for the next executive meeting, I suppose.
Yeah, because the dean is the one that gave us the last two rooms.
Yeah, I was speaking to the dean, like, last year, the work was where his dean is just
going to be up. Okay,
yeah,
I believe Julia Pryor is talking with Cody about getting us the software development studio.
Yep.
So I think that we just have a limited access to that.
So what does that mean? What is that studio?
I believe it's just a hackerspace. General resources.
Right.
Okay.
I've been a part of the studio. It's an alternative to taking basic programming fundamental software type classes, and instead you go there and you get into small teams of about five or six, and you work on a software project for a client. So they have like the sort of 7, 30, 40 students mentoring the other ones, and sort of acting as a project manager. So they sort of do a subject instead of like a project management subject. I guess the guys with no programming, they come in as first years and sort of work as, you know, work
they would have hopefully a steady flow of skilled and passionate programmers around.
Okay, can we then put some servers in the corner?
That's it, sir.
And maybe a bookshelf and a couch.
A couch.
There's already couches in there.
All right.
It's like a little pod setup.
Yeah.
I don't know how many, like, from my impression of
struggle if
it's over on that. I don't know how many people share it. It's not like a property. It's not easy. It's a workspace. It's like
this. Is there a locked door?
It's all key card access these days.
Yeah.
There's a locked door, six pods with whiteboards and that type of thing, and then that space kind of like this one at the front of the projector. Yeah. And we can have like a time where that can just like, you know, on a Thursday afternoon, just sort of be our space for the night.
Is this the space within the hatchery?
In the good old days, we were across the road from a brewery.
Yep.
Where?
just there.
We ended up building a ton of breweries.
The entire block of Carlton United breweries. Yeah. Smelled like it too.
Now the other STEM societies, do they have spaces?
No. Nobody's got a space at all. Even the other societies that did have spaces have got them booed.
Is it ProgSoc getting kicked out of what?
Yeah, ProgSoc doesn't even, that whole floor doesn't exist anymore.
It doesn't exist.
It's being demolished just like our
Right. That's probably because they're approaching the union and not the dean.
Yeah.
So I'm just saying, we should get the dean.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
and you should probably pull that resources to Gina, I think.
Because if they've got a pool now, if she's in charge of all of the engagement between the university and any, like, company, which is pretty much the university's source for all its money.
Yep.
Oh, government as well.
Yeah. Oh, you're sure the government. But they just sort of, they just get the government.
So,
there's one more event that I forgot to mention, which was just another learn to program event at the Hatchery.
Yep.
Which is
a ProgPoint this guy there.
Yeah, we do ProgPoint. That's it every year.
Yeah, I mean, just on the other STEM societies, I mean, has there been much collaboration in terms of coordination, if you will, in terms of finding a space?
As far as I know.
Could it be in your best interests to share a space?
I agree. As far as I know, we've been involved in all of their efforts to get a space.
Right.
We've been to a couple of meetings that that guy that ended the whole effort up.
Yeah. Forget his name. Nobody. Starts with B.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. I suppose. Paul is his name.
It starts with B. He probably tells it.
It's Paul Babbage. Is
Paul
his name.
Babbage.
That's, I think that's what the B came from.
Oh, Babbage.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a Labour man.
He's a Liberal.
Yeah. He's not.
Oh, okay. I've got
people
still. Okay.
He does look like.
That's all we got.
The incoming
supporter.
Probably not.
Okay. I think what Jacob is trying to say though is that effort has been put in individually and collectively into trying to get a room. And it's not just anything we've been doing. The other societies have had issues and they've had the exact same outcome basically. So either the next step is to, like you said, pursue the dean, or an alternative would be to pursue some sort of sponsorship, or possibly with Hatchery. I don't know.
Talking with Hatchery. I don't think it's a good idea.
No, it's like one point. Yeah. Hatchery just sort of. But the danger of spending money right now is putting on like an FEIC ball. He wants to get it socialized. He wants to get it behind the students. Like this ball with like three balls to him, for instance. He's at a charge of 35%. He's obviously losing quite a bit compared to me on that. So he's obviously got all the money that he wants to spend. And it's just, I think it's just about asking for it. Because another man once, like you said, he pretty much approached and asked for $2,000. So like, we'll just have it.
Is that the space?
Yeah.
Did that work?
He was on board. Like, I don't know. He was obviously a thing that's going to take a couple of years, but. Yes, but he's got cash to spend. And from his experience at RMIT, he has been going to have that. So.
Alright. I just want to say there was progress with getting a room when I was in charge, but then they fired it in Parker when I was going.
Yeah, Lindell
so,
was
so
with
so
us.
So now there's no contact.
Lindell was our best bet for quite a while.
I was working with her for a good 12 months on it.
Yeah.
And she was the only connection really that cared. So,
yeah.
And now she's got five.
She was the one who got us the porch van room, and then when she left, we lost that room.
She got the sign. Yeah. Why'd she get the sign? Oh, downsizing. Same with Jenny Donovan. She got the same. They were like, we don't need you anymore.
Okay.
It made a whole bunch of people redundant.
Yeah.
Like, merged heaps of roles.
That seems changed.
All these studios. Now, we can't just have a class. That's been like 200 people in a room with one lecture. Well,
Is on his way with the pizza.
Great
day. He's got a cool gift shop.
So, what's next?
Boom. Bus. Nice.
Yeah.
So, new bus is mainly based on
want any pizza or yeah?
I'll put next time.
If I like to. Hey, you told me
about this. I'll get
basically working with those guys. we might as well actually work with virtualization.
So
I'm not opposed to getting rid of hardware if there's a practical reason.
Yeah.
I like hardware, I want to keep hardware. I like one of the things that we have is hardware, people to practice with and play with.
I suppose virtual servers, not just virtual accounts. Is that something DigitalOcean can provide?
Yeah. Okay. All servers, people, well, even to be quite frank, they don't even need the society for that anymore because the DigitalOcean, each student gets $100 a credit and it costs like $5 a month to open up a server. I think I've got like two running that just like that's how insignificant they are. So if it reaches the point where we can't sustain hardware, then I'm not uncomfortable with going digital.
We 10 or 12 years ago did a thing where ProgSoc used to have a menagerie of hardware, every CPU imaginable, every architecture. Because we had a lot of engineering students who used it for both coursework and funsies, and then that stopped. We had this giant ass menagerie of stuff that one person occasionally used. And heading towards that, it was a big deal to take all that stuff and get rid of it. But going away from it, I don't think it was a big deal once it was done. And this is probably exactly the same thing. Unless some people are putting their hands up and saying, I really want to administer something physical, it's probably time, and it's probably way more educational for people here to learn how to virtualize stuff than to learn how to install and uninstall memory, is my thinking, in terms of marketable skills.
Mm.
So, yeah, from this end of the room, go to virtual, just get rid of the hardware. Unless somebody is actually flailing their hand saying, no, I want that thing. No? Nope.
I think that...
You may have it personally.
Yep.
I think there's certainly value in having hardware in terms of just basically...
I agree that there's value in having hardware. I don't want to get rid of hardware forever. But I'm saying in the time that we don't have space, in the time that it's sitting in somebody else's server rack, losing value, maybe we should get rid of it for now. And that actually want to play with hardware and we have the space to support it, we can go back. We can buy another server.
Someone was keen on something and they said, hey, ProgSoc, I want to be able to learn this thing. In order to do that, I need this asset. Like, whether or not we already had it, we would probably find a way to get it.
Yeah.
So if we have servers already and they ask for them, we go, sure, here you go. Or we don't have them and we're like, yeah, well, we can.
And I would love to help for society. So, yeah.
What are you programming?
What?
So you're programming.
Programming. Where do I start? So I started off back in the days of like VB, and I was like, wow, this is shit. And then I moved from VB onto C++, and that was for the Raspberry Pi. So I've done that kind of like small Arduino, Raspberry Pi kind of stuff. But then now I've moved on to a more web stack, like React and React Webpack, that kind of stuff now. So yeah, and I've done this Java stuff that everyone's learning here.
And any, what other events specifically would you like to do?
One thing I'm really keen on is hackathons, because I believe they come up with some really nice ideas, which I've seen and I've heard from a lot of my friends in the industry. So I've got a friend who works at MI9%, and they come up with hackathons, and so many of the features that they come up with in that 48 or 24-hour period actually get implemented into their sites. And I think that's a great way to generate ideas, and in the end, it's all about innovation, right? So the best way, I believe, for further information is through hackathons.
So we'll be filming things for hackathons, or we're running our own as well?
Running our own, not so much. What was the other one? Sorry,
competing in
other hackathons.
Competing in other hackathons is definitely there, but I would like to run our own as well.
Yeah.
More because UTS wants innovation, and as a society, if we can provide that to them, maybe they can give us things like goods.
Were you at Code Today in 2014, our hackathon that we ran?
No, like I said, I haven't been involved in any of the events, so yeah,
right.
I would like to definitely come to more of these next year as well.
Cool.
Were you at uni in 2014?
I was not at uni in 2014 either, so that was
funny.
I thought we were talking about hackathon, the one that I had
done
last year.
No, we actually have done a hackathon ourselves.
We did have, right, but it didn't happen this year.
No.
2014.
No.
Or last year again. Right. Cool. Yeah. Any other questions, guys?
Have you presidented anything before?
No, I haven't, but I would love to give everything a shot. So, yeah, here I am.
Yep.
How much time do you have on campus?
Yeah, Yeah, on campus. Next semester, the biggest issue for me is going from England to December is exchange. So that's going to be an issue. But apart from that, I've got two subjects of internship, 19th year. So campus time is going to be, I'm not going to be too big on campus, I think. It's not going
to
be
good. So is that October to December?
Is my exchange, yeah.
Okay, so yeah, that's pretty easy.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, okay.
Just talking to her and getting her to get us a room and angling for a give us a room because we need it because we're in a room, but give us a room because you need us to have a room so we can do all this stuff that you actually want to happen.
Yeah. Who's Julia?
Julia Pryor is the director of student engagement and something. She got like the BIT program and then some people and then her and the dean. And she also does all the stuff to do with industry and engagement and that type of thing.
Sure, well. She's taking over the job.
No, she's taking over the job above Jez as well.
Okay.
Jez and Anna both got up everyone in season 15, I think, and now there's one person who does that job. Any other questions? Yeah.
Okay, so what exactly is your plan to do something different to get rid of this ground that you can do others can't? What is your plan if we don't get a room? Let's say you seem to be independent on that.
We don't get a room.
Or you don't get a room.
Because
it's normally like just like everything you said is about the room.
Yeah, I think the room is extremely important. If we don't get a room, we'll find a space where we can still meet up. Like, getting a room which is a dedicated place which we like kind of own and we can control is one thing. Getting a place which we're allowed to meet up and run events in regularly is probably a lot easier.
Okay, so
in the sense that Julie's already said that we can use the SDS.
She said that?
Yes. It's possible we can do it. We need to do some paperwork and that type of thing. But like, she's gonna do it when it can happen. Whether or not we're like,
we should definitely do that. Private space.
Yes. I don't think the SDS will be suitable for a private place just because there are times in the week where they do need to run lessons. I think there's only like 6 hours, but it's, you know, you're running to get Monday, Wednesday night, that type of thing, so you can't use it for 2 nights a week if you kind of do need your own place. That will probably be harder, considering that people have tried for that a lot and it's not really happened. So whether or not that can happen, I don't know, as Jacob said, like, if the uni doesn't want to give us room, I'm going to do it, but we'll definitely try it. You know, whoever the executive, I'm sure, will try as hard as they can to get that room.
Yeah.
Correct.
Mostly.
Anything just like
So is there is there any other nominations for VP? So far we only got Jesh. So
congrats, Jesh.
Secretary?
Secretary Tegan. Any other nominations? Treasurer, Brenton? Anyone want to compete?
Somebody's
going to go to missions that I want to do.
My life is like a horse
station. And